Here again, it is your unscripted friend, Tall Bike Tommy, Community TV. Oh, and I just saw my helmet pop up in the background there. So, I guess today, the local creep catcher party, Jeff Lee Illerbrunn, who also goes as Jeff Ujat, and Jeff Lee on Facebook, runs the Medicine Hat Creep Catchers chapter, did a live broadcast today, and I guess during that live broadcast, I mean, I was blocked from his page, so I can't watch anything. I was blocked, obviously, because I criticized them. But anyways, they did a live broadcast today, and apparently it was all just like, F that guy from Community TV, F him, he's stupid, blah, blah. So anyways, I had a few people, you know, contact me and tell me that they had seen that broadcast, which I think is pretty funny. You know, it doesn't really hurt my feelings, but it just goes to show where the creep catchers are at. You know, it's like their fledgling organization is not doing so well. They've got a whole bunch of really bad PR on their hands. And it seems like now the only people that are following them are sort of, you know, diehards on the side of being against pedophilia, but just really aren't looking at any of the other possible outcomes when a vigilante group like this is given all this power. One of the big problems we've had here in Medicine Hat is that very recently there was a story where somebody who had done absolutely nothing wrong had their photo posted by one of these local creep catchers, and then the creep catcher went online to say, "My bad." And a lot of people thought that "my bad" really isn't a good enough excuse when you're dealing with such serious things, and that a lot of people are very concerned and upset that they haven't seen improvements with the investigation tactics of these creep catchers over time. I think a lot of people, like myself, were excited when we first saw this emerging idea on the internet, thinking that people could use technology and their own cunning to get dangerous people away from kids. You know, I think we could all look at that and say that is a great idea, but what happens is that, you know, people who have criminal records, who, you know, don't have a really great education, who are not really good at investigating or researching, they don't have any concept of how Canadian privacy laws work, or why we would protect victims' names, or how we would protect victims in all these very, very complex situations of sexual crime. You know, these types of crimes deserve the utmost of professionalism when being dealt with, and you know, that just simply can't be done by a group of vigilantes who are not very well vetted and who don't have training in proper investigation and how the police actually work with these things. Now, I was going through a little bit of old video, and as you see, I got my screen up behind me here. I'm gonna play something. I'm just gonna turn the volume up nice and loud here. This is one of the videos that Creep Catchers locally in Medicine Hat posted a while back when they got their t-shirt maker.
I got off the phone with Rachel and I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna go get it.
The profit said any profit that goes back, we're gonna replace whatever you spent on this guy.
Okay, so first, I'm just going to pause it there. So that's Jeff right there saying, whatever profits we get from selling t-shirts are going to go back into the purchase of the t-shirt machine. So I guess they're going to pay themselves for the t-shirt machine. Donate profits to charity and kids, and we hear them kind of go, oh yeah, and then we hear somebody in the back, oh, there's a charity right over here. So, you know, I mean, it might be a charitable case there to get some new furniture for Jeff. It looks like he's got red tuck tape covering up the holes in his couch, but is that fair? If the creep catcher movement is out there selling all this swag, the t-shirts and hats and all that stuff, and you have no idea where the money is going, are you okay with it if one of these people is just pocketing that money, or possibly spending it on drugs, as Jeff has alluded in one of his previous comments on Community TV. You know, when I challenged them about this, you know, I put up a criticism, basically. I put up a post that said, hey, it looks like the Creep Catchers organization is losing steam a little bit here, and they had this problem with posting about somebody who did absolutely nothing wrong and then having to make an apology about it. You know, I put up that criticism there, and Jeff comes through, and in the comments section, just basically all he has to offer is, oh yeah, well, I was at a place where I did cocaine and you did it too once. And I'm like, okay. So the first time the Creep Catcher organization all met down here in Medicine Hat, I went there, and I'm not going to say where it was. I'm not going to name all the people that were there, just because I think that that's a useless, silly thing to do. But since Jeff has wanted to talk about it, you know, I guess it is worth talking about. I am not a cokehead. I don't do cocaine regularly. I think I've maybe done it about 4 times in my life, and that was one of the times. I didn't feel extra, you know, I didn't feel anything. I didn't feel high or anything like that, so I assume that maybe they had something that was just like flour or something, or baby powder, maybe some baby laxative or something like that. So, yeah, it wasn't a profound experience of any kind, but I feel like it's just really funny when Jeff comes out and the first thing he has to say about somebody who's criticizing the organization is just to point at them and shame them in some way, as if that's the only kind of way they know how to do things now. Like they've programmed themselves to believe that, you know, you publicly shame somebody and then you win. And it's like, okay, well, you've attempted to publicly shame me by saying that you saw me do drugs once. Now, I could totally deny it because he has no evidence of it and all of his witnesses have absolutely no credibility whatsoever. It might not even be true, okay? It could be a complete lie, but I'm gonna go along with it and say, yeah, Jeff, sure, that's absolutely true, bud. So what else do you have to say? What more is there? After you criticize my who I am or what my lifestyle is, let's get back to the point at hand, which is talking about what Creep Catchers are and what they are doing, what they profess to do, and the value that has in our community, because I think that value is sorely lacking, and I think all we're seeing now is a group of misfits that are out there to try and get lots of likes on Facebook and lots of video views, probably collect revenue off of some of those video views, and in their popularity sell all kinds of t-shirts to people who you know, want to support this cause, which, you know, I think that's a great thing, to support this idea. At first, I supported this idea, but now that I see where it's going, I don't support it at all anymore. And Jeff, if your whole message out there in your live video broadcast is F me, I feel really sorry for you. I mean, I'm not going to fight back at you. I have no intention to fight with you at all. I just want you to look at what you're doing, question the validity of what you're doing, and really ask yourself, is this something that's helping the community? Is it really? You know, long-term, all effects of what you're doing, is it really going to help the community as a whole? And I think that's the discussion that we have to have. You know, I think it's, like I said, a great idea to begin with, but I think it has to be done with a very high level of professionalism, and you have to be willing to improve yourself every single time that you're doing this kind of operation, and I just have not seen that. I haven't seen any improvement whatsoever. I've seen that every time somebody has criticism for you, you're blocking them, deleting them from all social media, not accepting what they're saying, and even going so far as to say that those people are pedo supporters, or those people are Skinner goofs, right? So I wouldn't be surprised if you've called me those names, if in the Creep Catcher sphere of things, I'm probably now some kind of you know, Skinner goof, pedo lover, or something like that. But it just, like I said, it goes to show how they operate. If you have a little bit of criticism for them about how they're doing what they're doing, they instantaneously jump to, this is a two-sided thing, you're either black or white, and you're on our side or you're against us, and that's really not the best mentality to have when you're dealing with such a sensitive topic. I'd like to know your comments on this, and, you know, if you want to watch that video there, I'll include a link to it and see if it gets deleted in the next little while. Bye-bye.